We letting the scouts outside. We running the scouts.
So, Canes lost. So now, thanks to the Bruins scoring 4 goals in the 3rd period, Carolina is 1 game away from getting eliminated. As I mentioned, Boston scored 4 goals in 6 minutes, 51 seconds to give them a 4-3 victory over the Hurricanes. So Jake DeBrusk ended up having 2 goals for the Bruins. Connor Clifton had a goal and an assist. And Brad Marchand scored in his 3rd straight game for the Bruins. And Yaroslav Halak, who is of course now the goalie for Boston due to Tuukka Rask dropping out, he made 16 saves in this game. Also, this is the Bruins' 2nd win in 3 games without forward David Pastrnak, who is unfit to play. And they now have a 3-1 lead in the series. And they now have a 90.6% chance of winning this series. I think only 29 times have a team leading 3-1 has lost a series. So that is good news for the Bruins, as they are also the 4th seed in this series. James Reimer made 29 saves for the 5th seeded Carolina Hurricanes, and the Canes were also outshot 16-2 in the 3rd period. Game 5 of the series is Wednesday at 4 o'clock, which is tomorrow. Also, that's on my birthday, so that should be pretty cool. Hopefully the Canes, you know, can win on my birthday, because that'd be pretty nice. So, fun fact here, this is the 2nd time the Boston Bruins have actually scored 4 or more goals and allowed 2 or fewer shots in a playoff period. The first time they actually did this was against the Hartford Whalers on April 11th, 1991, where they scored 4 goals and allowed 2 shots. And they are only the 2nd team to do this. They're the 1st team to do it twice. The other team is actually the Edmonton Oilers, who scored 4 goals against the Chicago Blackhawks and allowed 2 shots on April 24th, 1983. So, 7 minutes, 26 seconds into the 3rd period, Canes were up 2-0. The puck was, you know, coming towards Reimer, and Reimer dove out of his net to get it. DeBrusk got there first and kind of like whacked it away and then went and buried it in the empty netter. Anyway, so that made the game 2-1 Carolina. And then Connor Clifton, from a bomb from the right circle, tied the game of that 2 at 10 minutes 10 seconds into the 3rd period. Then Brad Marchand on a breakaway, God I hate him. Brad Marchand, the Rat, on a breakaway, scored 5 hole on Reimer and made it 3-2 at 11 minutes and 40 seconds into the 3rd. And then 14 minutes and 17 seconds into the 3rd, Jake DeBrusk got his 2nd goal, scoring close in front of Reimer with a wrist shot, so that made it 4-2 Bruins. Then, with 1 minute 27 seconds left in the 3rd period, on a spinning backhander, which happened to be Carolina's first shot of the period, Tuukka Teravainen went glove side on Halak and made it 4-3, so gave it a little bit of an exciting ending, but of course, the Bruins held on to it and Carolina lost 4-3. That would be your final score. As for the other 2 goals, 9 minutes and 17 seconds into the 1st period, Justin Williams scored above the left faceoff circle and gave the Canes a 1-0 lead. And then 12 minutes and 8 seconds into the 2nd period, Jordan Martinuk, with a nice little wrist shot, beat Halak club side, and Canes were up 2-0. And then you saw what happened. And then, of course, we got to address this. 9 minutes, 53 seconds into the 3rd period, Jordan Staal left the game after taking a heavy hit from Charlie McAvoy. From some angles, in my opinion, it looks like he might have got his elbow up, but from other angles, it looks like a clean hit. So, I don't know how to feel about this. I think it's a clean hit, in my opinion. At least from the latest angles that I've seen, I find it a clean hit and a good hit by McAvoy. But, of course, that's going to be up in discussion, you know, probably for a while. Another controversial things the Bruins have done. Hey, I hate the Bruins, but I mean, yeah. And keep in mind, Canes were already without Andre Svechnikov, who, you know, got injured with that whole Chara incident. Some people say it's a classification of Chara's a monster and he's a lot bigger, so obviously he's going to take down a little Svechnikov. But then there was other people saying he, like, kind of, like, can opener to him and, you know, like, kicked his legs out from under him or whatever. Like, I still am not too sure how I feel about the Chara incident, but the McAvoy thing, I do think it is a clean hit, at least from the latest angles that I've seen the hit as. But yeah, that's my little take of it. And obviously, due to the NHL's return to play protocol, they can't really disclose an injury. So we have no update on how Gordon Staal is. So, we're just going to have to wait and see. So, two little things before we end this sucker up. First off, the quickest the Bruins have ever scored 4 goals in a playoff game is actually Game 6 of the Stanley Cup Final in 2011, when they scored 4 goals in 4 minutes and 14 seconds to give them a 5-2 win over the Vancouver Canucks. That came in the first period, by the way, in a span of 4 minutes and 14 seconds in the first. And another thing, the Yaroslav Halak, becomes the first goalie since Tim Thomas in 2012 against Washington to start at least 2 games for Boston, who's not too good asked. But Tim Thomas played all 7 games against the Capitals in the 2012 second round Eastern Conference quarterfinals. Besides that, that was the last time someone not named Tuukka Rask was played more than 1 game, like, in a playoff series. Starting, like, straight games or consecutive games. They've been riding Tuukka Rask in the playoffs for a long time. They're the only goalie they want to start back-to-back games, but obviously due to personal situation, he couldn't be there. We still don't know what it is. We'll probably never find out, but we're just going to see what happens. Anyway, that's all I got for you guys. And if you did enjoy this video, make sure to leave a like. Make sure to subscribe down below. Let me know your thoughts. Who you guys want to win this series? Who you guys came for in the Stanley Cup playoffs? Let me know everything, because I deserve to know everything. No, that's a joke. Make sure you click, you know, turn notifications on so you know when a new video comes out.